بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. ربنا افتح بيننا وبين قومنا بالحق وأنت خير الفاتحين. ربنا آمنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا وآتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد. Brothers and sisters, beautiful children, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Once again, we are here in the house of Allah, celebrating one more night from the last nights of Ramadan. And I can see, mashallah, the brothers are full of energy and full of determination, inshallah, to make their best, or to do their best, inshallah, to make the best use of the last 10 days of Ramadan, hunting for Laylatul Qadr. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us the full reward of Laylatul Qadr. Allahumma ameen. We know that about Laylatul Qadr, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indicated in Surah Al-Dukhan, فِيهَا يُفْرَقُ كُلُّ أَمْرٍ حَكِيمٌ أَمْرًا مِنْ عِنْدِنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا مُنذِرِينَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the night of Qadr will disclose some of His future decrees and decisions for the people. So the angels will get to know what tasks they are to do for the next year. So one of the things that make this night so special and so significant and so important, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided on this night to disclose the future, or the rizq, the provision, the lifespan, whatsoever people should get for the next year from the night of Qadr. So the people actually will receive from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decide for them. But the question is, and probably this question is in your mind and also in my mind and so many people's minds, it doesn't make any difference if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already decided and decreed everything in advance. So why should I make dua? Why should I do my best? Why should I try? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already written my name in the list of the people of the Jannah, then I will make it no matter what. So I don't have to bother myself, because my name is already there. So I don't have to worry about it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows in advance if I'm going to go to the Jannah or otherwise. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the Jannah. Allahumma ameen. And if my name is written in the list of the people of the hellfire, there is no point to try, because eventually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's decree will take place no matter what I'm trying. The scholars actually had a long debate about this point. The dua is going to change the qadr, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already destined, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written down. If this is the case, then we should do our best and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to choose for us the best, to make our future better, and to change our status from good to the best, inshallah, and from bad to the best, inshallah. So the scholars actually come to an agreement based on the evidence from the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and from the discussion about Laylatul Qadr, and from the Quran, of course, first of all, that if you make dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to change what is already written for you. But it doesn't mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changes his mind, hasha lillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't do something and then feel there is something better than that, so he changes his mind. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a plan for every single individual of us. And part of from this plan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put something on hold for us. And this is a conditional gift. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has something for us, it's a conditional. If you fulfill the conditions, Allah will give it to you. If you don't fulfill the conditions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not give it to you. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows in advance if you are going to fulfill these conditions or not. So it is on hold, and it's your own choice. And if you do your best and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to change your condition from bad condition to a better condition, from disobedience to obedience, from sinfulness to ibadah, whatsoever, from a condition to a better one, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, will change that based on your sincerity and your good intention. The evidence is what I have recited from the story of Prophet Yunus alayhi salam. Prophet Yunus alayhi salam, he was given a task by Allah go to this particular nation. It was a city. Go to this city, call the people to Allah, and stay there until you receive a further notice from Allah. He went there. He talked to the people about Allah, invited them to believe in Allah, and no one actually accepted his call. He tried his best, and nobody actually accepted his call. So he came to a conclusion that this is a hopeless case. Those people are lost. There is no point to waste my time anymore with those people. So I better just go and find another place so people may have like a softer heart, or maybe have a better condition. They might accept my da'wah. So without waiting for Allah's permission to leave, he decided to leave. And he, for him to leave, to travel from this city to another city, he has to ride the sea. So he went on a ship, and it happened to be a tough weather and a tough condition. And the waves, were just like mountains, and the people on the ship were about to drown, all of them. So after some discussion, they decided to reduce the load on the ship. They said, we have to reduce the load on the ship so we can survive. What we're going to do, throw our own luggage or whatever we have, they did. And they need some extra load to be removed from the ship. So they draw cast, and then they draw lotos, and they find out that the one selected was Yunus alayhi salam. He looks a very good person, very nice, very handsome. But they tried again and again, and finally it was just proven to them he is the one who has to be thrown into the water. They carried him like a cannon bolt, and then they throw him in the water. Landing in the ocean, he didn't land in the water. Actually, he landed in the mouth of a whale, al-hut. The whale was jumping out like that, opening his mouth, and then he swallowed him. He kept him in his mouth. The mouth of the whale has different caves where there is air and not water. That is why he was breathing for a few days. Some scholars said 3 days. Now the point is, this is the point I'm trying to make. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَوْلَا إِنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ. If he were not excessively engaged in tasbih and making tasbih all the time, لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was going to keep him in the mouth of al-hut until the day of judgment. Allah would have kept this hut, this whale, alive until the day of judgment. And Allah would have kept Yunus alayhi salam alive until the day of judgment. He would be staying there until the end of the time, subhanAllah. But because he was asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take him out and to forgive him and allow him out of this condition, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed him to get out after some time. So the first plan was to keep him forever. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changed this plan, and he allowed him to get out because of his tasbih. فَلَوْلَا إِنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسْبِحِينَ أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. What was his tasbih? What did he say there? He said, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. So this was his tasbih. And the tasbih is to believe full-heartedly that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala far away from imperfection. In other words, Allah is perfect, and whatsoever comes from Allah is perfect. Whatever plan comes from Allah on my own way, it is perfect. Couldn't be better. If Allah decides to take away my happiness, it's perfect for me. If Allah decides to take away my children from me, it is the perfect plan. If Allah decided to make me poor, it is the perfect plan. And that is the meaning of subhanAllah. Allah doesn't make mistake. Allah doesn't make some kind of weird plans for the people, doesn't target the people, doesn't have anything personal against anyone. Because some people are so funny, they said, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just targeting me? The people have the earth has 7 billion people. Why me? Why Allah? Looks like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking revenge of him, has something personal, or free from any other things to do, and he just waiting for him to put him in trouble. حاشا لله. فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. So this is an evidence. The scholars actually quote. They said, if you make dua, sincerely make dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would change the bad things that may have to come in you or into your way. Subhanallah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ الْبَلَاءَ لَيَنْزِلْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already planned for a bala, trials, tests, calamities, tribulation, coming on your way, coming on the way. Just landing on the top of your head. فَيَلْتَقِي بِهِ الدُّعَاء. And you are sending the dua. فَيَعْتَلِجَانِ. It's just like two rivals fighting each other. إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. Keep them fighting. So you haven't received the bala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved you. So the bala is already sent. So the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is fulfilled. But at the same time, your dua is going to stop it from coming to you. Subhanallah. This is the benefit of the dua. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, مَنْ أَحَبَّ أَنْ يُنْسَأَ لَهُ فِي أَثَرِهِ وَيُبْسَطَ لَهُ فِي رِزْقِهِ فَلْيَصِلْ رَحِمَهِ. Any one of you would like his rizq, his provision, to increase, to expand, to increase his wealth and his rizq, whatever rizq it could be, sahha, health, wealth and happiness, whatever. وَيُنْسَأَ لَهُ فِي أَثَرِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extend his life, فَلْيَصِلْ رَحِمَهِ. Let him be good to his kith and kin, his relatives. If he's good to his relatives, he's kind to his relatives, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expand his rizq, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will extend his life. Some scholars said it is literal, which means that Allah give you longer life, so you can earn some more years. And some others said, no, it is not that, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put barakah into your time. So the thing that you can do, or you need to do it in 1 year, Allah will allow you to do it in 1 month. So now you have saved yourself 11 months. So this is the meaning that your time will be so longer, will be longer than usual. So Allah will free your hand from so many commitments, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will allow you a lot of free time so you can use it in the ibadah or so many other good things you can do in life. Otherwise, Allah may shorten your life, not by taking 1, 3, 2, 3 years from your life, but by keeping you busy so you feel that the time is flying and you can't do things that you need to do. You just imagine, subhanallah, brother, every day is weekend, subhanallah. Just every day of the week is just like the first day of the week. I don't feel there is a week. It's just one 24-hour day, and time flies very quickly. So this is how you feel the time is very short. But in reality, time is time. 24 hours, 60 minutes, 60 seconds, that is how time it is. But what I want to say, the point is, when you make dua, especially in the last 10 days of Ramadan, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove any barrier from your dua to make his way, to make the way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send the angels to receive your dua even from the earth. You don't have to submit your application to reach the sky. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send the angel in a charge coming to you. So the government office will come at your door and say, give me your application. You don't have to submit it. I'm here to take your application. Make your dua, subhanallah. If you do so, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inshallah will decide for you the goodness, will decide for you a happy life, a successful life, a rewardable life, a meritorious life. Whatsoever goodness you are looking for, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will decree for you on the night of Qadr if you deserve it or if you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that. And that is one of the objectives of hunting for Laylatul Qadr, inshallah. So brothers and sisters, make sure that the remaining part of your Ramadan, inshallah, is the tough time for yourself, but it is actually the juicy part of the month. Here I am, Ya Allah, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik, I am here to seek your reward, to make dua, to engage in ibadah, to cut myself off anything that may distract me from you. I will be in your service and asking you whatsoever I want, and I'm sure, 100% sure, 1,000,000% sure, that whatsoever I'm gonna ask, you will give it to me in the way you think it is good to me, not in the way that I think it is good for me. This is how the dua work, and this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decree for us the goodness, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us the people who win in the month of Ramadan, in the night of Qadr. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us the people who are forgiven by the end of the month of Ramadan. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'afu anna. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'afu anna. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'afu anna ya kareem. Kumu ila salah. Stand up for prayer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept. Jazakumullahu khairan.